I'm fortunate enough to be on the board of a great museum here in Brooklyn called Mercatum, and we were having a fundraiser, and I bought this in the auction.
And did you know who it was when you bought it?
At the time, no. There was a lot of buzz about this artist that and I just started to learn about the artist with my involvement with the museum. But I didn't really have much of a history of art or knowledge of background in art, so it was all new to me at the time. It was years ago.
And what year was that, do you think?
I don't remember. I think
approximately
maybe
5 years, 10 years.
It was more than 5 years ago, so I would say maybe 8 years ago.
The artist is flavor of the month. This artist is so hot that his market has gone from paintings, let's say, you know, large-scale paintings, selling for $150,000, which is a substantial amount of money, to the record this past December 2020 was over $4 million.
Titus
Kaphar. Yes. This is a working collage. Only one collage by Titus Kaphar has come on the market in the past 5 years. It sold in December of 2020, and it sold for $27,000.
Oh, wow.
So what did you pay for this?
I don't remember. I do know it was nowhere near that. I think it was maybe $1,000. I have to double check with the museum, but I think it was maybe $1,000.
Yeah, well, you did really well. You're a great stock picker, and I want to know who else you're looking at, because I want in. Titus went to San Jose College and got a BA in 2001. He went to Yale and got his MFA in 2006. So when you think about this just 14 years to go from being an art student to achieving incredible notoriety, and he's a young man. He is just at the beginning of his career. So, you know, there's buy, hold, and sell.
Yeah.
This is hold. How do you read the subject?
What I love about Titus's work, and then really the art that resonates with me in general, is its ability to tell stories. And I've looked at this in so many ways to try to interpret the story. Obviously, I think it speaks to the experience of Black Americans here in the United States, as much of his work does. I see there's an angel there as well. So there's the aspect of religion, and it's these beautiful faces, stoic faces. And then there's a car. I think part of like a working class experience, but I also could be projecting a lot.
Well, we all bring in our own experiences when we view a work of art. And Titus, in particular, looks at the canon in art history and takes these well-known works of art and overlays the African-American experience. One of his most famous works is a scene of the Declaration of Independence, and Muhammad Ali is standing on the table. It's interesting how he pulls back the veil and makes you think about how African Americans helped to build our country and the backstory for lots of different eras. In this case, this is an Enunciation. Although it wasn't titled when you bought it, Titus has since entitled the work New Enunciation. It's a collaged work, and he found this image of an early French 19th century artist named Amré Duval, and he collaged it in with this wonderful image of this working woman. So the angel of the Enunciation is announcing the God child. Mm-hmm. So in many ways, to me, I read this as almost an adoration of the shepherds. Mm. And there are lots of art historical classical overlays, like this column is used in pre-Renaissance art as the symbol of the New World Order with the birth of Christ. Mm-hmm. You have here African-American merchants juxtaposed with working people. It's an incredibly rich, multi-layered not only art historically, but culturally. Mm-hmm. Image, and I think it's phenomenal. I think that the value for your work by Titus Kaphar is about $30,000. That would be a good insurance value.
Oh.
Because you would need to, you'd have to pay that to get another one.
This is what I do when I'm like at a loss for words or nervous. Okay, wow. This right here, Titus, I love you.